This is Jim Jubak for Jubak Asset Management on YouTube. This week, this video is one of the series called Quick Fix. And my quick pick this week is CRISPR. That's C-R-I-S-P-R Therapeutics. They're a gene editing company. I think gene editing is going to be a tremendous new technology. It's going to take a long time to go. I'm going to put this one in my millennial portfolio, which is for people with time frames of 10 years or longer. CRISPR is the name of the technology itself. And the stock ticker is CRSP. The good news is the stock got the first FDA approval for a gene editing therapy. They partnered with Vertex Therapeutics, that's VRTX, this is going to be, it's the first one, it's the sort of the validation of this technology producing real medicines, real therapies. The interesting thing is that when the company came out recently, the stock got, with earnings, the stock got hammered. We're talking about, it lost 8.5% last week. The reason for that is that, this company really doesn't yet have much in the way of revenue from products coming in. So last year, it had some pretty good milestones, revenue milestones that made partners like Vertex put in money. So they didn't have those this quarter. So the year-to-year comparisons look really, really horrible. The revenue fell roughly 99.5, not 100% year to year. And the 2023 loss the 2024 loss was about twice what it was in 2023 per share. So the knee-jerk reaction was sell, of course, because these are terrible results. Well, these are terrible results, but they're totally predictable terrible results. After all, if you don't have any revenue coming in, and you had a big lump of revenue in the past, your revenue is going to look really crappy. And that's what it did, and that's what the stocks lost. So you have a chance to get in on a company, one of the core companies, I think, in this technology, at a relatively reasonable price right now. And what we're looking at is we're going to start clinical trials of a gene editing treatment for lupus. That's roughly soon. And they have ongoing trials for gene editing therapies for cancer and some autoimmune diseases. They just raised money. This is another reason why the stock went down. They did a rights offering in Canada. They raised about $167 million, which, of course, dilutes the stock. They've got about $2.1 billion in the bank at the moment from the offering and past payments from partners, which is way more than enough to get them a long number of quarters down the road. It looks like last quarter was about $167 million in cash flow negative. So if you say $2.4 billion in cash, you can run a lot of negative quarters for that. The drug that did get approved was the first treatment for sickle cell anemia, and it got FDA approval. As I said, it's the first CRISPR therapy to get approval, first gene editing therapy to make it to market. The revenue split with Vertex is about 40% for CRISPR and 60% for Vertex. So pretty clear that we're not going to talk about bringing in huge amounts of money immediately. So what you're really doing is buying a stock which has been temporarily depressed on totally predictable bad news with a lot of good stuff in the pipeline that's a fairly long way away in a market that no one is exactly sure how to figure out the size of this. Like, these therapies are not cheap. It's a new technology. The FDA may approve it, but doesn't mean people as insurance companies are going to add it to their formularies. So how's the reimbursement going to work? All those are uncertainties. That's why if you want a stock to buy for the next 9 months, not this one. want to buy the stock for maybe the next 9 years. I think this is a really interesting play right now. So if you found this video useful, entertaining, amusing, colorful, I got a red shirt on today, please go to my YouTube video channel and subscribe. It's for free. And you get a notification when we do our next ones. We're doing about 3 a week, but not always on the same day. You can also subscribe for free. You can also sign up for my JubakPicks.com site, which has got 3 portfolios, not the one this is going to go into. This is too long term. Those portfolios are 12 to 18 months. They are dividends. They are stocks with 5-year time horizons, something except longer than that. So if you want this another portfolio beyond that, 3 more portfolios, you can go to my subscription site. That's JubakAM.com. That's got also a portfolio for really long term, 10 years, I would say, or more. So if you're a young investor with a lot of time to play with, these are stocks that you might want to consider owning, like CRISPR. There's a volatility portfolio on there that looks at ways to hedge volatility, sometimes do some options. And the last one, the last of the 6 portfolios is there's an ETF portfolio, 5 ETFs. So that's the subscription site. You can usually find an offer discounted by about 20% somewhere around where your mailbox is. If not, write me and we'll send you a coupon code to let you get it for 20% off. Last thing, my wife and I moved to Italy in September. We're going to be here for probably 5 years or so. So it's been something that we've always dreamed of doing. We're in Venice right now. We're going to move to Sicily for the summer. And we started a Substack called We Moved to Italy, also free to subscribe. You can find that on Substack under that title, We Moved to Italy. We'd love for you to be able to follow our adventures or amusing anecdotal experiences as we travel around in our new nomadic existence. So thanks very much for watching.